played his hand so far.
Sorry, mate, can you take me to City Hall? Boris Johnson drumming up support with cabbies this morning, promising them a free run in every bus lane and a voice on the board of Transport for London.
They've had a pretty rough deal over the last few years, and there are some very simple things we could do to make life easier for the cabs and to get the traffic moving again.
With just over 100 days to go, it's time for detail from the Henley MP. The gap, say opponents, lies in Boris Johnson's policies and his grip on detail.
Victoria knows this figure. It's either 112 officials or 232 officials.
Mr. Johnson last week penned his last Daily Telegraph column after 20 years of writing it, but faced a showdown with the man whose job he wants over just how much he really wants it.
Tell me how many times on the floor of the House of Commons you asked a question about London or made a speech about London.
I'd like to know.
Or even used the word London in your 6 years before you decided to stand for mayor.
I'd like to know what you've
been doing. OK, we need a concise answer to this. This is the last question.
You never made a single speech. You didn't ask a single question. You mentioned the word London once when you referred to foot and mouth.
A keen cyclist, Boris Johnson's promised to get rid of bendy buses and reform the congestion charge, as well as putting live CCTV on all buses to help cut crime. All messages that went down well with this morning's audience of black cab drivers. But will they see him ride to power? Karl Mercer, BBC London News.
And I'm pleased to say Conservative mayoral candidate Boris Johnson joins me here. A very good evening to you. Shall we begin with the congestion charge? Because there are just over 100 days, as we heard, until the election. You say in your policy the congestion charge must be reformed. That's such an easy word to use, but what does it actually mean?
Well, for instance, I don't think the Western Extension is working very well. It's delivering huge numbers of cars into the central charge zone, and I think probably we should get rid of it.
So you'll scrap the congestion charge?
The Western Extension I'm talking about. And as for the congestion charge itself, if you look at what's happened in central London, in the central zone, we've had a 15% increase in congestion this year on last year. It is not delivering the cuts in congestion that it promised to do. And I think we need to have a fairer system, a system that makes use of better technology, and a system that doesn't penalise people who just nip in and out, while some people pay exactly the same for going in eight or nine times during the day.
In that time where we need to understand what making it fairer means. When you say not penalise people who are just nipping into the congestion charge, how will you actually do that?
Well, Riz, you're going to have to wait a little bit longer to see exactly what we bring forward on the
congestion charge. There's only 100 days to go.
I know, but I think the Londoners will be very, very interested to see what we're going to do on that. But I don't think you necessarily need to be charging the same whack throughout the day. I don't think you need to be hitting people across the board with exactly the same.
So the message on congestion charge is it will be there, but wait and see.
And one thing I absolutely guarantee, we will be less punitive than the current regime. I think it's unbelievable that Ken Livingstone is taking £55 million in fines from Londoners for the congestion charge. We will institute a regime that gives them longer to pay, 5 days as opposed to the current regime, and we will make sure that the maximum fine is at a more reasonable level of, say, £40, as they have in Sweden.
Let's stick with transport, because it is a big issue for Londoners. We went out today, and here's one question directly for you, Boris Johnson.
How much can they cap the rail fares, the underground fares? Because every year it just goes up so enormously.
I would like to say to Boris Johnson, what are you going to do about the rising cost of transport in London?
Well, Boris Johnson, what are you going to do about that?
It's perfectly true that fares have gone up very considerably under this mayor. And if you look at what's happening with people, suppose you want to get a tube from, you know, through a one-zone tube fare, it costs you £4. It's higher than almost any other capital in Europe. I cannot believe that it's impossible to do something for people who might be workers coming into London who don't have an Oyster card. Well, let's look at the huge amounts of money that are being spent by Transport for London on their own civil servants. There are 112 officials in Transport for London who are currently earning more than £100,000 a year. Bus subsidies are now running at £680 million.
So will you look at capping rail fare and tube fares for passengers?
I'm certainly going to look at making it less punitive, less shocking to the system for those who want to use the tube on a one-off basis. It's certainly true that you've got to be absolutely clear about this. There is a good argument for trying to encourage people as much as possible to use the Oyster card. It is a very sensible way of getting
around. You say less punitive, but you did approve a design for a different type of bus by Autocar magazine.
Riz, I didn't approve it. 400 million.
Are you in favour of it?
What I said was that it had superficial attractions, and that when I get in, as I very much hope I will, we're going to have a proper competition in which that, of course, can be an entrant to design a successor to the bendy bus.
Getting rid of bendy buses will cost, won't it?
Well, it's very hard to... We've been trying to cost it, but it's very hard to work out exactly. Transport for London is being very, very difficult about this. Actually, I don't think it would cost that much, because you'd simply tell the bus companies that they had to reschedule their contracts and gradually pension off the bendy buses and get and hiring and hiring
will cost 80 million.
Hiring new bus. Well, they also say that we'd have to have conductors for the whole new fleet, and that's not true. So I do think there are plenty of people in TfL, plenty of bus enthusiasts like me, who are looking forward to a wonderful new successor to the bendy bus, and I do think they want a new route master.
Boris Johnson, we've got so many people who want to ask you so many questions. Let's move on to another big issue that Londoners want answers to.
Go on.
Just listen to this.
Well, how would they solve the crime problems that are going on, I suppose? Just throughout, no matter what it is, I suppose, at local level and across the whole of London.
I do think this is the number one issue, and it's something that... It's really one of the main reasons I'm coming in to do this, because when I was a kid in London, 30 years ago, it wasn't as scary as it is now. And irrespective of the figures that you can produce showing that vehicle crime has gone down, or whatever it happens to be, people don't feel as safe. What I want to do, particularly on the knife crime and the gun crime with the young kids, which is the thing we've seen particularly in the last year, I want to have CCTV on the buses, a live trial of CCTV, so that the police can see when there are violent affray is something they need to get to. I want to have handheld scanners so that people can tell at a distance whether someone's carrying a knife or another offensive weapon, and you don't have to go to the hassle of stopping and searching them, which causes such confusion and information.
It's important to hear all of these ideas. For example, though, one of the other mayoral candidates, the Lib Dems, Brian Paddick, has said that if crime is the number one issue for Londoners, he's the man to tackle it. Yeah. And he's pledged to cut it by 20% or stand down after the first term. Are you willing to put a figure on it?
I think, obviously, I'm really willing to listen to whatever anybody has to contribute to this debate. But I have to say, I don't think any particular purpose is served by having another target and another statistic. What people want is to feel that their streets, their buses, their station platforms are more secure. And there's a very good social and economic reason for that, irrespective of the feeling of safety.
So, Boris Johnson, are you saying that as mayor, regardless of the stats and what the stats say about crime, as mayor, should you care more about facts and stats or about people's feelings and how they feel on the street?
I think what you need to do is make the buses, the streets, the station platforms much, much safer. And I think a lot of people, statistics are very important, but a lot of people feel that they're not reporting crime at the moment. I think there's an epidemic in London of unreported crime because people feel that it won't make any difference because the police will be too busy to respond. And so lots of minor burglaries, minor thefts, things like that, are just not getting reported. I want everybody's crime to matter. I want to recriminalise offences that are now just taken as run-of-the-mill.
Can you understand that a lot of people who watch the programme feel that you don't give specific policies and numbers? What they feel is that you're kind of...
I've just given you two specific policies to deal with gang crime and knife crime. And above all, what I want to do is get more police out on the streets, and you can do that by getting the PCSOs into the back room to do some of the things that the police are currently doing.
Even though police numbers are at a record high at the moment.
Well, it depends on how you read the statistics.
Those are metropolitan police figures.
In terms of full-time operatives, they are down this year 259 on last year, in terms of full-time operatives. And I defy you to correct me on that.
I could correct you. I wish we had the time, actually.
I happen to know I'm right. But the important thing is that we can do better. And if you look at what happened in New York, where they got a much higher proportion of their operatives
out of the streets. We're going to pick up on
those. We can do better.
We will pick up on those metropolitan figures.
Are you bringing me to a halt here?
I'm afraid I have to.
We must come back to this. This is the crucial issue.
I'm sure we're going to hear a lot more from you in the weeks and months to come. I do hope so.
Riz, it's been a pleasure.
Boris Johnson, many thank you. Many thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Well, over the next 2 days, we'll have the mayoral candidates from the other two main parties on our programme. Tomorrow, Mayor Ken Livingstone will be in the hot seat, followed on Wednesday by the Lib Dems' Brian Paddick, who officially launched his campaign today. The former Met Police Deputy Assistant Commissioner says his key priorities are improving the transport system, increasing affordable housing and cutting crime.
I'm not going to run away from difficult problems. I'm going to face them head on. So I am going to tackle the gun and knife crime on the streets of London. I am going to reduce crime. I'm going to take responsibility for those issues. And I'm going to say I'm going to be held accountable for those issues. If I don't do the job, then people can sack me.
Brian Paddick there. And don't forget, if you want to email any questions you'd like to put to any of the candidates, that address, as always, yourlondon@bbc.co.uk. Don't miss the chance to do that.